After DLC, the data of max 64 bytes are sent on CANFD, followed by SBC, which stands for Stuff Bit Count. CANFD was built as an extension to original CAN bus protocol. But why was CANFD developed in the first place? As you might know, every protocol is developed to solve some or other problem related to existing protocol or to fit to a new use case altogether. In this case, CANFD was developed to improve CAN protocol considering firstly the explosion of data because of increase in vehicle functionalities, secondly network being limited to 1 megabits per second bandwidth for CAN with data frame restricted to 8 bytes. So to cope with above two factors, OEMs were working on complex and costly workarounds with CAN protocol. Hence the main intention of developing CANFD was to increase the data and data transfer rate. With introduction of CANFD, the data transfer rate was raised by 5 times, with large frame size for use in modern automotive electronic control units. Let's start with the name. CANFD stands for CAN with flexible data, meaning ECUs on CANFD can dynamically switch to different data rates with larger or smaller message size. So the data rate can be switched fast or slow depending on the network and pack more data within the same CAN frame and transport it over CAN bus in less time. ECU on CANFD can use 11-bit identifier or 29-bit identifier as classic CAN, hence making it easier to replace current CAN. In case if you are unaware of 11-bit identifier or 29-bit identifier, please check the CAN bus series to understand these terminologies. The message payload size has been increased to 64 bytes of data in each CAN frame compared to only 8 bytes in classic CAN frame. Let's look into the frame format of CANFD. As with classic CAN, we have the start of frame bit followed by identifier bits. Again, if you are unaware of CAN frame format, please watch the CAN protocol series to get more info on CAN frame format. So after the identifier bits, we have the RRS, that's remote request substitution bit in CANFD compared to RTR. CANFD doesn't support remote frames, hence this bit is always dominant. Next we have IDE, which is similar to IDE in CAN frame format. Then we have FDF, replacing R0 in CAN. This bit is set as recessive, indicating that the frame is CANFD frame. Then we have 3 new bits added in CANFD compared to CAN frame. First bit is RIS bit, that's reserved for future protocol, which is by default set to dominant. Second bit is BRS, which stands for bit rate switch. When set dominant, means that the CANFD data frame is sent at arbitration rate up to max 1 megabit per second. When set recessive, means that the remaining part of the data frame is sent at a higher bit rate up to 5 megabits per second. Lastly, we have ESI bit, which stands for Error Status Indicator, which is by default dominant, indicating that the node is error active. But if the node becomes error passive, then the bit will be set to 1. Again, if you are unaware of error active or error passive, I would highly recommend you watch the below video. Then we have DLC, which has classic CAN is 4 bits and denotes the number of data bytes in the frame. DLC value from 9 to 15 are used to indicate data size beyond 8 bytes. DLC value 9 would mean data size up to 12 bytes, 10 would mean data size up to 16 bytes, and so on. After DLC, the data of max 64 bytes are sent on CANFD, followed by SBC, which stands for Stuff Bit Count. SBC consists of 3 gray-coded bits and a parity bit. Gray-coded bits, also called as reflected binary, are bits where they remain consistent with consecutive bits. Coming back to CANFD format, after SBC, we have the CRC of 17 bits for 16 data bytes or 21 bits for 20 to 64 data bytes. The data payload of CANFD data frame stops at acknowledgement bit, which also marks the end of potentially increased bit rate. So you can see with slight change in CAN format, CANFD becomes the most convenient protocol to upgrade to for existing networks. Even if the network is migrated to CANFD, if some ECUs are not, then the ECUs can still communicate on CAN protocol. That's the beauty of CANFD. It's not just upgrading the network, but also providing compatibility for the CAN ECUs.